Welcome and congratulations to the team of Ukraine. First position, second France, and third Germany. Ukraine, in Hochfilzen you made it second position, and today you just used five spare rounds, which is really amazing at these conditions. Julia, can you tell us about the course conditions?
Поздравляю, в Охфильце второе место, сегодня первое место. При этом условия очень сложные, вы всего лишь пять раз промахнулись. Юля, какие чувства были, или как вы ощущали условия сегодняшние?
Условия были тяжелые сегодня, честно. Такая погода, нехти. Вот, ну, ничего, справились, как видите, с условиями, поэтому... Довольно очень результатом не ожидано вообще. Так что все умнички, девочки умнички. Спасибо.
The conditions were very hard. I mean, the snow was very tough. It wasn't easy at all, but as a team, the girls did an amazing job, and we managed to get through. And so I'm very happy.
Why? What do you like less? Wet weather like this or very cold weather?
Валя, что вам меньше всего нравится? Мокрая погода какая-то или очень холодная погода?
Что хуже,
да?
Я думаю, что и та хуже для меня. Лучше солнышко, когда тепло, плюс 5, так едешь сюда. Ой, минус 5, едешь, погода тебе улыбается, все. Тут стоишь мокрый, холодно, дрожь по телу. Какая же это хорошая погода. Я думаю, что это не для нас.
Well, to be honest, I neither like wet weather and I neither like cold weather. I prefer nice weather, like the sun and minus 5. It's like the weather is smiling to you. Like in today, it's horrible because it's wet, it's cold, and it's very tough. So no, I don't like this kind of conditions.
Olena, you become now a frequent guest in the press conferences. Do you feel you have more confidence with each competition now?
Olena, вы у нас станете очень регулярный гость в зале пресс-конференции. Какие чувства, ваши чувства самоуверенно растут каждый раз, с каждым гонкой?
Наверное, все-таки растут, потому что когда первый раз была на подиуме, я также сидела, как Юля, у меня руки трусились, я не знала, что сказать, и была масса эмоций. Но сегодня уже как-то все эмоции более-менее спокойны, и гонка прошла достаточно уверенно, и как бы я следила за каждой из девчонок. И очень приятно было, что все ровно, стабильно и потихоньку приближались мы к золоту.
Basically, yes, I mean, the first time I felt like Julia. I was very nervous, but now indeed my confidence is growing and I'm a lot calmer. And also in the race I feel that we have a good team and we can manage a very good performance. And yes, I'm happy to be back here, and it was a great day.
Vita, did you feel any pressure in the final standing stage, unless you had a large lead?
Несмотря на достаточно большой разницу между вами и Францией, у вас все-таки было напряжение на последнем.
Да, у нас только было слегка небольшое напряжение, и мне очень хотелось удержать ту стартовую позицию, которую мне передала Лена, и финишировать с украинским флагом. И как бы я со своим волнением внутренним справилась, и хочу всех поздравить с таким прекрасным новогодним праздником, новогодним сюрпризом для нашей команды.
Yes, regardless of our lead, I felt a bit of pressure. Because I wanted, of course, to bring home the victory, and even though at 40 seconds I felt the pressure, but somehow I managed to control my internal pressure, and I was really dreaming to cross the finish line with the Ukrainian flag in my hand and bring maybe a wonderful New Year's present early in the year for the team, and I want to congratulate all my team members with the victory.
Marie-Laure, France, last year you have been here on third position. This year, in the first part, your team struggled early in the competition with the first exchange 11th position. Did you still thought you make the podium?
Do you say I was bad?
No. A little problem.
Okay. No, it's true. I fell in the first corner. It was not an advantage to my relay because I spent a lot of time, but it was like this. After I tried to fight harder on the track, and my first shooting was fast and clean. My second, I missed two balls, but it was like this. And I was lucky because my friends were pretty good today, so thank you, girls.
Actually, we saw a lot of crashes all through the teams. Some of the women managed well, the other lacked confidence in the downhill. Have you done any training on these downhills, especially?
I think we practice a sport where we need a lot of confidence in downhill. It's our job, so of course we train every day. So. But sometimes we are unlucky, so it's a game, I think.
Anaïs, was your shooting in the whole team the key to make the podium, because your whole team just needed four spare rounds?
I think it's a part of the key, because it's not enough. We make a biathlon, and we need good shooting and good skiing, and so it's not the only part.
To Germany. Nadine, does this crowd have made you getting the podium position, or did it make you more nervous?
Also, es war sehr aufregend auf jeden Fall erstmal zu laufen, und die Zuschauer, das war einfach eine tolle Stimmung, und man muss es einfach nutzen, dass man motiviert da hochläuft, und die haben einen angeschrien da hoch, sondern lässt sich viel leichter laufen, muss ich sagen.
It was really exciting, and the crowd really makes it easier to get up all the hills and to manage the competition quite well. Tina, what was the hardest this evening? The soft and slow snow, the rain, or the fog?
I think it was all of that. It was really hard to ski today. It was so deep, and I feel like I'm running on the sand or something like that. And yeah, and the rain and the fog, it was really hard for me to see it something. So that was also the reason for my crash on the downhill. So I haven't seen it, and I was falling down.
Can you remember a combination of such conditions in any other competitions?
I think we had such conditions here last year, when I remember. And yeah, I've trained under that conditions the last 2 days in Altenberg, in my hometown. So yeah, I got used to it.